There's Jim.
Hola.
Hola. So I'm just explaining what we were doing.
All right, so hit the subscribe button. Come along on this journey with us as we turn our 1994 Bluebird school bus into a full-time RV. Come on.
So last week we showed you a little bit of what we were doing in the front of the bus. Here Jim's just getting all the wood and all the supplies so we can finish up the project. Okay, so here's what we've got going today. This whole area right here must get built out. We went and bought a couple pieces of plywood, some 2x4s, some 2x2s. I think we even bought a couple 2x3s. And we are going to be finishing that out and building a cabinet there and a cabinet right there. You can hear Jim in the background. That's what he's doing. He's cutting the 2x2s for bracing the actual cabinets. And in the meantime, I have one electrical outlet here. And this right here is right where the TV bracket is going to be going. So I have to undo this. Put it all the way over here next to the cabinet here. And I'm gonna put a second one in for over here because of course we're gonna have the PlayStation or the Xbox or whatever the heck it's called. I don't really play it, okay? I'm no good. I want to quick explain before I go any further. We are doing this right here is our cabinet. Okay. This is going to be enclosed with the door, the whole bit. I do not like having to put everything away and strip everything down every time we move the bus. And we haven't moved it that much. So we will be. But I watch a lot of you guys on YouTube and on Instagram and I go, oh my gosh, every time they move, and they move every couple of days or every day. No, I don't want to pack everything up, put everything on the floor, in the sink. I don't like everything sitting out. We have a 55-inch TV. Yes. See what a roof raise can get you? Yes, check out that playlist. We have a roof raise playlist. Jim and I did it ourselves. Ding, ding. You can do it. I think it cost us around $1,300 to do the roof raise ourselves. It cost us a ton of time. Ain't gonna lie, a lot of work, a lot of time. My upper body got very ripped, so there you go. Jim just took off to go do some deliveries. Jim delivers food as a supplemental income. He goes and delivers every single day. And so that's why I build most of the bus. DoorDash is no joke. I want you to know if you are doing an RV nomad kind of van life thing, traveling around, DoorDash is a great little income. Yep. If you're doing, if you have van life, you could do it just your van, whatever. He makes somewhere, depending on how much he works, $700 to $1,400 per week. $700 to $1,400 per week. Now, our cost of living, if you take away the bus, is about $1,500 a month, We will have a video later on that. We are still trying to figure some of that out. And when I get details, I will put up a video. Yeah, so hit the subscribe button. Yep. What does it cost to live this way? It's not that much. It's stupid cheap. Stupid cheap. I'm gonna have a link below. Check out the link. If you hit our link for DoorDash and you sign up, when you do your first 200 deliveries, which is, it sounds like a lot, but it's not. First 200 deliveries, you will get a bonus on top of your regular pay. So you can get paid weekly, you can get paid daily. So I love to say this is brought to you by DoorDash, but it's really not. DoorDash is not paying us. However, if you use the link below, Jim and I will get a little money too. So it's just a great way to support the channel. It's a great way, if you are thinking about this way, sign up and check it out. It is very simple to make some extra cash in the heat of the moment, if that's what you need to when you're on the road. Super easy. Check the link below.
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow's glistening. A beautiful sight, oh, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is a bluebird, here to stay is a new bird. He's singing a song as we go along. Walking in a winter wonderland. Well, in the meadow we can build a snowman and pretend that he is positive and brown. He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no, man. But you can do the job when you're in town. Later on, we'll conspire as we dream by the fire to face unafraid of the plans that we've made.
Rolling. Recording or time-lapse?
Tell them what else happened yesterday while we were in the middle of doing all this.
So, whilst in the middle of all this, talking about the car?
Yeah.
I went to go do a delivery and get gas after the delivery. Pamela was at the laundromat doing our laundry while I did a delivery right quick, and my starter blew up on my truck. So, fun times.
Bye-bye, Suburban.
Fun times. Fun times.
2x2.
Thank you much.
I do not have another one.
No, that's totally good. I got another one.
Okay, I do have a 2x3. And a
2x4.
I have a
2x4.
What?
I got a 2x3 out. A couple of 2x3s outside.
Okay.
My line.
What'd you say?
No. Suitable for children.
Elle might as well watch him. Oh my god. There's this little kid in the background. He's all dressed up. Diesel heater, before you shut off power, you must shut off the diesel heater, let it cycle down, and then shut off your power.
Piece up here with the arch on it. I'm not too worried about this seam because I'll just touch that up. But then this seam I'm not overly concerned with
they're having some gaps up here because the ceiling is going to come down about right there. And it'll cover all that and also help hold it in place. So I'm just going to tack it along this bottom edge. Finished. In the name of the words of Jesus, it's finished. Well, not finished.
Not finished.
But it's boxed. So now I got a caulk, do some trim on it, paint.
Who's painting?
You.
Beautiful. So we got most of it finished. We put up the TV and put some things in the cabinets. Jim and I's Merry Christmas was a mini entertainment center, perfectly suited for our 55 inch.
Well,
we went and saw
them
this way.
Yeah, we stayed to spend Christmas with the kids, and they got sick, and we can't spend Christmas with the kids anyway.
Nope, and now we're a little snowed in.
And now we gotta wait till...
Literally, the bus is kind of snowed in.
The great thaw of 2020.
Kind of wishing we had a ginormous pot of coffee, so that we go around and give coffee to people. because there's a lot of people out on the streets.
A lot of homeless folks here.
A lot of homeless. Look, if you ever see people that are out, you know, buy them a cup of coffee or a donut or whatever it is that they need.
They're still people.
They're still people. What we've learned the most is they just want to be seen. So say their name. Look them in the eyes. They're not going to bite.
Thank you.